Good morning, friends. I'm so glad that you're with me today in the sanctuary. Today we're talking about one of my favorite things to drink. I cannot imagine that you can guess what's in my basket. It is made out of water, leaves, spices, and maybe some herbs. Can you think? What do you think it is? Now when I say it like that, it sounds kind of gross, like someone took a big vat of water and added like what you find in your yard and put it in there and maybe some spices. And it sounds yucky. But what I'm talking about, you've seen before, it's tea. That's all that tea is. I'll even open my little tea bag. It comes in a little sachet, which is a fancy word for this little bag. And all that's in here, and you're really not supposed to open your tea bag, but I just wanted to show you what is in here. All that's in here is little ground up leaves and spices and herbs. And when you put them in water for a little bit of time, when you wait on it to do something called steep, that means that it sat in the water for long enough that the hot water draws out all of the flavors and all these things, that this green tea becomes a drink that is so tasty and delicious. But if you don't let this little package of leaves sit in the water for long enough, it tastes just like hot water, which is bleh. Maybe you like hot water, but I'd rather drink tea. Now, what's really important about tea, and amazing about tea, is that if you asked Miss Ellen to go out into the wilderness and find a bunch of leaves and berries and twigs and stuff and to make tea out of them, I would not be able to. It really takes someone that knows all of the things that traditionally go in tea together. Someone that has all that expert knowledge is called a tea master. And the tea master does all sorts of kind of science experiments, cooking experiments with tea recipes to make the tea that we buy in the grocery store. And so by the time that we get it, it's just like a gift. Because someone else has already done all this work to figure out what A, is not poisonous, and B, tastes good together. It's just such a big feat. And we don't even think about it because we just take our package out and we put it in our teacup and we call it a day. Now, there's a lot going on right now, right? I like to think of everything that's going on right now, almost like all the leaves and things that are going in tea. There's a hurricane, there's a pandemic, school is not how it usually looks, everyone still has to wear masks, our whole schedules are still a little jumbly because we're still figuring out how to live really vibrantly, really fruitfully, really joyfully in this time. And from those things to the things that we're seeing out in the world, that we have serious racial injustice, that we have fights, that we have riots, that we have all sorts of nasty things being said as we head towards our presidential election, it can feel like that combined with what is happening in our own personal life, it can just feel like so much. It can feel like we're looking out into our yard and just seeing all these leaves and twigs and herbs and stuff that we don't know what to do with. But here is the good news, is that God doesn't cause bad things to happen to us. God does not speak all these things into being to mess with us or to teach us anything. That wouldn't be a good God that is worthy of us coming together to worship. And we know because Jesus loved us so much that that cannot be true. What we know as the good news of our faith is that we can have hope in a better future. One where God sorts out all of these leaves and hard things, and God holds all of the hard and big feelings and walks with us. So that someday we have something like tea that just comes to us as a gift where everything is sorted out and it's all in the right order. we have something beautiful and delicious made out of a big batch of chaos. That's who our God is. And so having faith right now might just look like keeping the hope that there's a better future in front of us. We know that God will be here with us, and that God is preparing us just like tea sits and steeps and has all sorts of good and bad things pulled out of it by hot water. That we will eventually come to a place that's a better future than right now. And we can believe in that future because we believe in Jesus. That if Jesus can die and be resurrected from the dead, if Jesus can heal people, if Jesus can take all of these things that look like chaos or people that felt like they were at the very end of their rope and give them a better future, that's really who God is. And God is working on our future right now. So if this week, if you feel all these things piling up, if you feel like you're looking at a big batch of leaves, remember that we can have hope for a future that looks way better than this. Because God loves you. God loves you, and God sees the potential of all that you are. And God will use even this, even the hardest stuff, to make a better future. Thanks.